So let's start a chair, side view, so the right line. We could start at zero actually, zero. Or shift to be straight. And then another line, start at the end. We could have used polyline too. And we'll go somewhere there. So now we can join both, Control J. Let's move this here. And to run this, fillet. So one is 1 square on the grid, so we'll do three. Click once, click twice. There we go. Now we need to offset this line. Distance depends on your drawing. 6 might be good for me, both sides. And if it's going the wrong way, you just click on in custom play. That seems a little bit too wide, so 5, 5. Also, it closed everything. It might be because corner sharp, that's cool. Oh, cap flat, that should be to none. Both sides to yes. Voila. Now we want this to be rounded a little bit. Still think it's a bit too wide, but. Custom plane, all good, both sides. Voila. So now to make the top a hair longer and the bottom, we go F10 to show point. Grab this and just move it and try to keep the same angle and just a little bit. That would do a lot, might even be too. You press Alt so it doesn't go snap. Voilà. And you could do the same here. So F10, select the first one, move it out, press Alt just a little bit. Then we can loft. So we select the three curves. And here it's important to rebuild, we'll have a clean surface. You have to be careful. If you rebuild with 10, we're losing a little bit the shape. So let's go, let's say 24. Now it's much better. We don't need those curves anymore. We'll get rid of this. Now we want to offset this, so offset surf. This time it depends on your drawing, maybe 0.4, 0.5. Solid to no, because we want a surface, and loose to yes. That means you'll get the exact same surface on the other side, same number of lines. And we usually go from the outside, but you could flip the direction if you had to. Now we're gonna trim this on an angle, so plane. A big plane like this, and in this view we'll move it and rotate it. So when you rotate, you can press Alt to cancel your snap just a little bit. Mirror, zero, hold shift. Then we can go trim this and this, 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 this. Voilà. Delete this. Uh, line. Here to there. Sweep one. Here to here. Cross section here. Must have picked them the wrong way. Well. Why is it doing this? Is this correct? Oh, sweep two. We need two rail, not one. Here we go. Now we can see that the continuity is not great, so we can go add slash and draw one. Can hold shift here. Draw another one here. Draw one here. Join, Control J. Now we could do a fillet edge, not too big, maybe 0.1. Voila. So that's the top of our chair. As long as the legs, as far as the leg goes, different technique, but one quick one could be like this. Press Alt so it doesn't snap. It's a bit short, so I'll go F10. Move this down. Mirror. Somewhere here. Hold Shift. Draw a smooth curve. Command is called curve. Press Alt, you're not O-snapping. Fillet. And radius could be 2. Here to there. And here to there. Now you do need to join those. So, well, actually they are joined. We could space them a bit more, and you could go F10, fix some of this. Very pretty here. Press Alt to cancel those now. That looks a little hair better. Yeah. Pipe. So start of the pipe, press Alt just a little bit. And here even less. You could also type numbering. Sometimes that's a bit thick, but we'll keep it for now. Mirror. We could do a good connection, but if they are touching, as an STL, this will 3D print. Yeah, like this, that should work. Control-Shift-E, and voila.